What's good, YouTubers? Your boys, Aaron Shy, back at again with another reaction video. Hey, fuck you guys before you say anything, because I can sense it. I just felt it in my spotter sense retainer. You about, your lips are as big as Jay-Z's. You about to say that. Beat you to it, bitch. But, then we got the Carters ape shit. Excuse me, it's on Beyonce's page. These are one of the few people who can drop a surprise album and it still do numbers. They're one of the few people. There's some people that be like, yeah, I'ma hit him with a surprise album. Then next to them, that shit go double motherfucking styrofoam cup, according to fucking academics. That shit trash. They're like, why would you not tell us, you bum? You gonna leave this for us? We don't give a damn about you. We didn't get, you could have told us 2 years ahead of time. We still not listening to that trash, you bum ass nigga. But yeah, Beyonce and them, they're in that other lane where they can do stuff like that. We know them. They built up a reputation and all that. They're solid, so I don't know how it's going to go. I haven't really heard too much from them in a while. I actually didn't even get to hear Jay-Z's album. Or, I feel like there was something else I missed. But I didn't actually get to hear it, so let's get into the video. Make sure y'all follow me on Instagram, too. Okay. Is that Lil Wayne?
Oh, Illuminati, okay.
Hold on, whoa. What the fuck? I need to get in that different tax bracket, man. Jay-Z can grow hair? He has hair? This man's like almost 50. With that amazing hair, that's a 20-year-old's hairline. Where'd you get that? I'm over here struggling. I'm like, damn it. And keep it together, Xavier. You gotta keep on working a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I'm be pulling a Kobe. Kobe had a .2 on his head. Oh, his barber was amazing. He just come through. Zzz, zzz, zzz. He'd be like, all right, look. Matter of fact, close enough, Kobe. That's the best we can do. He'd be like, all right, we'll do it. I'll just say I have hair on 2K. But yeah, man, amazing hair. And I love the outfits. The colors. Is that a fuchsia pink? It's sexy.
He got a bad bitch, bad bitch. We live in lavish, lavish. I get expensive fabrics. I got expensive habits. He wanna love me. He loves to roll away. He wanna play with me. Give me the vitamin K. Ice on him. Ice style.
Hold on. That dance is not gonna excuse. Give me that vitamin D. That's how you know you got a real woman, that she can make jokes like that. You had everybody saying surfboard and shit. And everyone's like, oh, surfboards, I love those. And then you find out that that's some freaky shit in the tub. I haven't tried that, all right? Because one, I can't afford a tub. Two, I don't know, that's that next realm of piping. I'm not on that richness level. I just gotta do generic shit, like fucking on a bed, all right? I don't get to do pools and all kinds of crazy shit, like, hey, let's go and fuck on the counter. No, I have to eat off that. I can't get 17 more, so, yeah, but what is the concept of this? Because I'm noticing a lot of famous paintings and all that. I'm seeing the Mona Lisa. I'm seeing, I can't think of the name of it. This shit looks beautiful as hell, though. These paintings, that's, but if you really break it down, someone sat there and was like, you're like, hey, you want to come outside? Hey, shut the fuck up. I'm painting. For months. Imagine just months you just sitting there dedicated to something. You know how hard that shit would be? That takes art, man. And it's pretty cool that they got the people dancing all that in a new type colorways that match it. You ain't on it. I mean, they're trying to convince us on this Illuminati shit, you know what I'm saying? Cut the check, nigga. I'm out here. I seen the title. I ain't gonna lie. I didn't say it. I didn't say it at all. I'm just sitting there waiting. I was like, is he gonna quote? I was like, is he quoting Chief Keef's Go Away shit? Hey, that, oh my goodness. I ain't even going in on that tape. That tape is fire. But that's dope. The fact that he even said that line, because that was just like a, that was just a mixtape. That wasn't even no album, nothing. Mixtape. He was just dropping it. Was it on Almighty? It might have been Almighty, or it was, it wasn't Bang. It wasn't Bang Part 2, was it? It was either Bang 2 or Almighty Sosa. I can't think of which one exactly it was. But, yeah, he, that shows you that Jay-Z's ears, he pays attention to a lot of shit. He probably might not say it, because if he says somebody, then boom, they're gonna blow up. Just like a Drake, a Cole. Not comparing him. Jay-Z is here. Alright. He's up there. He got that long money. He's already solidified. But that shows me that he pays attention to music still. He's just like, because you know, with Kanye, he pays attention to what's going on around him or with his friends and all that. But he's not glued into what's going on fully. Jay-Z, and I remember Joe Budden talking about that. Actually, I forgot. I think it was on the podcast. He was saying he has his ears. He still pays attention to music. He loves the new stuff. Like, that's pretty dope, man. Just to start a verse like that. Tell these clowns we ain't amused. Man, the clips for that monkey business. 4-5 got changed for you. Motorcades when we came through. Presidential with the planes too. One better get you with the residential. Undefeated with the cane too. I said no to the Super Bowl. You need me, I don't need you. Every night we in the end zone. Tell the NFL we in stadiums too. Last night was a fucking zoo. Stage diving in a pool of people ran to Liverpool like a fucking beetle. Smoking Rilla Glue like it's fucking legal. Tell the Grammys fuck that over eight shit. Have you ever seen a crowd going eight shit?
Give me the ball.
friendship. Hang one night with him, say I'll make you famous.
Oh, that outfit fire. Joy, was that my squeaking? This beat goes super hard. I do, and just to note this, because I didn't want to pause it too much, I do like the reference to the Super Bowl change, like turning down, like NFL need me. We don't need the NFL. Facts, man. These are one of the richest couples ever that are actually making power moves. It's not like, oh, making a lot. One's making way a whole bunch more, and then next time divorce and messes all that up. They are a power couple because Beyonce can drop something and do numbers. Jay-Z can drop something, do numbers. Has his own streaming site, doing numbers, getting paid off of that. He's very smart. And for some of y'all that might not know, I'm not the biggest Jay-Z fan, being 100%. I'd have to go back and listen to stuff, but I'm not the biggest Jay-Z fan. That's where it's like, okay. But one thing with him that I will always do is respect how smart this man is business-wise. And I remember Cameron even saying, when I was watching an interview with him, when he seen Jay-Z, even before he blew up rapping, he always had money. So I remember someone saying something like, oh man, he ain't that big of a drug dealer. He only got caught with a little bit. He got caught with a little bit. Think about that. He got caught with a little bit, all right? Just because you get caught with a little bit don't mean that you don't have a whole bunch. I mean, you might have messed up that one time and slipped on that. Like, you don't want to get caught with big shit. You're going to jail. That's stupid as fuck. You for a long time at that. So, Jay-Z always had money. So, he hustled. I do like the song. I like the style. It's dope that even after all this time, because, hell, Beyonce was doing her thing when I was a little kid. I'm sitting at like 6 or 7. Jay-Z, way before that. And they are still very much relevant to where they can drop something randomly and do numbers. That's crazy. That's amazing, honestly. I wish I could be on that level like that. So keep up with the ball shit, Jay-Z and Beyonce. If you like this, you want more, let me know in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe. Till next time, peace.